Why is your FPS so bad?
What?
Why was your FPS so bad?
No, it wasn't bad. I was just like getting a little bit of lag on some of the MG maps.
So basically making excuses.
No, I didn't lose. Did you lose?
Nah. It's 1-1 right now.
Hello? Am I back live? See if they're getting the server. So Powell's not playing in this game, right?
Yep.
Yeah, that's right. Powell is moving out of his house. He did tell me that.
He's what?
Moving out of his house.
Oh, really?
He's got like a bunch of bad shit going on in his life right now.
Ooh.
Like, parents are getting divorced and he has to move out. And like, some family members are sick and stuff. Should have just taken the trip to LAN and then just stayed in America. Made it by himself. Selling bananas on the street corner.
Oop, I won. 5-4.
Damn.
I killed him at the end right as he killed me.
Really? But you killed first?
No, I was up by 1 though, so he killed me first, but luckily my rocket killed him. Oh, I'm about to beat him again.
This song that just came on my Pandora is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. Oh, that's not a song. that was a Jump IT advertisement. I'm like, what is this song? Oh my god. All right. Where's the source TV? There we go. Put it in Mumble. Alright, nobody's in the server yet. It's okay.
Expected.
Boink is in the server. What a champion.
Props to him.
Don't know who he is, but he is the next nobody that shows up on time is good in TF2, so sorry, Boink. Do you think the next cast people would want the face cam on or no? I don't think it's that good on cast.
You have a face cam finally?
Yeah, I did it the other
day. Let me see.
The other day.
No, do you have it on right now?
No, because it's a cast.
So, put it on. They want to see it. They want to see your reaction when someone gets like a big ass shot. You gotta be like, whoa.
No.
People would want to see that.
Well, I would, but I'm just gonna start coughing halfway through the stream and I don't want people to see that.
You don't want to see them. The inside life of Platinum?
But maybe. Yeah.
Which one of your bots has your face cam? Oh, I see it.
Yeah. One, some of them. I have like 3 or 4, I think.
Yeah.
No, next time when I'm not sick and I cast, probably next week, I'll probably do it if people want it.
Who wouldn't want the face cam?
Well, it's a cast. You want to see everything.
It covers up like a 20th of the screen. I don't think people are going to mind.
Wow, good fractions.
Yeah. I bet that's extremely accurate, too. Also, make sure you ban Thorin from the chat if he's in there. He said he's going to rile up the crowd and stir up shit.
Well, if he starts
after I beat him in NGE mod, he's upset.
All right, Thorin, that's guaranteed. I mean, everybody knows that. But if you say one more negative thing, you're done,
everyone,
son.
Everyone who's watching the stream right now, just so you know, Thorin is an awful player, and I am much better than him in every way possible.
Yeah, that's right.
Look, he's trying to lie. He's lying in chat. Ban him. I gotta get something to drink before the start, since there's...
Yeah, I have water already.
I'll be right back.
Alright, guys. Well, welcome to the cast. Platinum, your host, accompanied by Harblue, Mr. Tony Ball himself. And hopefully we get a good match. Down to Pound just upset Zensity 4-1 on Viaduct. And Zensity was the number one seed going into these playoffs, so... I guess they're called Steve C Games now, so I guess I'm going to call them Steve C, because Powell is not playing, and Powell is their all-star, so this could be a really close match, and I hope it is. As soon as more people get in there, I'll start going over the rosters and stuff, from what I know. But it's going to, I mean, the two guys... Or I should say the one guy that could really turn the tide on this map is not playing. So it'll be interesting to see who the studs are that are going to step up and, you know, potentially be a threat to Invite next season. From what I know, what's the other team? Down to Pound is like full of ex-inviters from Mighty Ducks and HRG. So they've already got some experience. Steve C Games. Steve C Games is the one with Power that doesn't have Power, so it's just like, who's on their team? They got Kapow, who has never been an invite. They've got Rando, who could have made it last season if his team stuck together, but he's been a pretty dominant IM pocket so far. And they got a couple demo men on each team, I think, that aren't well known. So I don't know, it'll be interesting to see the mid fights and how they pan out.
Well, I think Christopher is pretty well known, I think.
And maybe in the IM circles, but he's never been an invite.
Well,
I was saying how...
At the beginning of this season, I think Chess Club, he was going to be their demo man originally, but I guess he wasn't good enough for them, so he's good, but apparently he's not the smartest demo man, and he cares about his stats a lot on it, it seems.
Yeah, you can't have a TLR on demo. It's not going to work out on your team.
I mean... Steve C Games has like just been really unlucky with their roster this season, I think, because they first picked up Oob on Scout and he played really well in their matches, but then he decided he didn't want to play sixes anymore, so they had Power then come in, and you know, both of them are both really good scouts, and now Power can't make this match,
so
I think that's gonna hurt them a lot this game, I think,
especially because Down to Pound is riding on the freaking high that they just knocked off Zensity 4-1 on
five. That's pretty crazy.
Like, if I was them, I expect they're going to come out this first middle and just completely roll over Rando and crew. And then I expect it to go back to even. But I think the first round, like, they're going to rape because they're going to be so confident.
The Down to Pound roster, like, surprises me. Because, like, none of the players on it are, like, were any of the, like, super top players, but they seem to just be, like, a really solid team and work well together.
Well, it's like half an old Ducks, half an old HRG, right?
I think it's only Rick from HRG, and I think...
Isn't Anonymous on the team? Isn't Snacks no. Anonymous?
Snacks isn't... What? No. Snacks isn't on the team.
He's on the roster.
Well, he didn't play in their Sensity match. It was Akum and Decimate on... they have Decimate. Never mind. They have...
Yeah, they got Decimate, from what I'm seeing, is Decimate, Doggles, Uckum. That's three X-Inviters. DBW's their medic, right?
Well, Doggles medic, then there's Entity match, so... Right.
Maybe that's why they won.
Yeah, they might use that... Oh, they're not using that lineup, yeah.
And they got Moero, also X-Inviter, from the
wild. Wait, is he playing this match, too?
I don't know, I'm just looking at their roster and just trying to guess who's gonna play.
Okay, I was seeing who played in his NC match, but they're already using a different one. They have Doggles on Soldier and DBW on Medic now, which I think is a better lineup than what they did before. I think Rick's backup for him.
Who was the last team to play against Wow Wow Kapow that I casted?
That we casted?
Oh, Vector. Vector had that one really good scout on Viaduct, and that was about it. His name started with an F, I forget.
I mean, Wow Wow Kapow, or, you know, Steve C. Games is coming into a 4-0 win against Vector, which is a pretty solid team, so, you know, they should be pretty confident, but they are missing their best players, so.
Yeah. That's like if you guys went into a match without me.
Yeah, we'd win still, easily. So it looks like these guys are gonna win.
And when you lost, you'd say you didn't lose.
No, I would definitely win that. You would have lost for making the team lose.
Yeah, Fife, I guess, is his name.
Christopher Games. I like that name.
Christopher C. Games. All right, we got 11 people on the server. So.
Why do I get the feeling this is going to be one of those hour-long matches that goes like 2-3 at the end of it? I hope that's not what it is, but I just feel like there's going to be...
That's what I think, because I don't think there's one player on each team that's going to really step up and just carry them to a role, you know?
I mean, if Howe was here, you know...
Yeah, that's what I said. That's exactly what I said when you were... Yeah, when you were getting water, that's exactly what I said.
But yeah, this is going to... I just feel it's going to be a long... not boring, but just painful at points where like teams are just holding...
I'll try to make it exciting.
You just talked about that and it made me yawn. Holding and suiciding one person. Like our scrim last night. At last. Like, oh, come on, just push. Just push, please.
Like, Snake Water is a good map, but it can just be so.
We should have just suicided two people so that they would have pushed.
I would have gladly gave them the scrim win, just so we didn't have to play the map anymore.
That 15 minutes at the end was horrible.
I mean, what practice did we get from that?
We stared at the walls waiting for Sizer to switch classes. Oh, we got 12 people in the server,
yeah,
alright.
I just noticed that.
We're really quick, aren't we? All right, so we got Control Muffin, who I've never actually heard of. I think I might have played an NGE a couple times, but I don't know much about his style. I have seen Christopher, so, you know, it'll be interesting to see the demo fights at the middle. I mean, I don't know how IM demos really play, and so I don't know if they go balls to the wall or they play like Banny or what.
Christopher is a really good DM demo, but again, he's not the smartest, so.
So he's like who, Kermit? Or like Dummy?
I'd say he's like Dummy.
He's like the Dummy of IM? Okay.
Yeah. And I really haven't seen much of Control F Muffin play, but I know he's been around for a long time, but I don't think he's like one of the really great DM ones.
Does he put out a lot of damage, or like does he use things well, or is he just mediocre?
I'd say he's just like a mediocre DM, but I don't know what his stats were in their last match on Game Sensity. He did a ton of damage on their Viaduct match, so... He might just be one of those devils who do a ton of sticky damage and spam.
All right, well,
like a Kermit or something.
Maybe he can step it up and carry his team to victory. Who knows? Anyway, the scouts for Down to Pound. We got Uckum, and is Decimate in here? Is he aliasing? Or we got Drogo.
Yeah, I guess Decimate isn't in here.
Looks like Drogo, who was playing medic, I want to say, in the last on the Viaduct that they played against Vector. Is playing scout for them now? I guess they could just switch it up.
Drogo's on Steve C Games.
He's just on the wrong team. Okay, that makes sense.
Okay.
These tags are like annoying to read.
Yeah. Well, they're.
Oh, what's
it's
the
easy to tell.
Show.
Decimates in here. Decimate and Outcome, which is a pretty solid scout combo. That combo could, you know, do good enough in invites. I feel like that's gonna be the way stronger scout combo with CC Games. Yeah, with CC Games not having Oob or Power.
Yeah.
There.
I mean, they've got. Who's their scout? They got Boink. Boink and Kapow, but Kapow was medicing the last
Boink's
time.
I think Boink's
Roamer. Alright, we'll go over this. Okay. We'll go over their rosters on the first rollout because these fucking guys switch rosters every goddamn match. So
it's so weird. Like, you know, playoffs is when you normally want to have your solid roster,
yeah,
all your starters, but.
Unless you're, you know, off classing for a round.
Yeah, but both these teams have
Who
different rosters than last match.
Who's gonna do that? Who would off-class in a match?
I know,
honestly.
Come on, playoffs.
It's not like you could possibly go undefeated. Off-classing. Alright, anyway, enough bragging like a faggot.
That was pretty DM of you.
Yes. So, if you're just joining us, welcome to the cast. Platinum and Harblue casting the IM. What is this, semifinals?
Upper bracket finals?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So it's pretty important. Zensity, number one seed, getting knocked out by Down to Pound, who is starting off on blue.
Into the lower bracket, yeah.
They got knocked the fuck out. 4-1 on Viaduct. They took a couple uppercuts to the face. So maybe they'll rebound and they'll be able to win it from lower bracket, but speaking from experience, it's kind of freaking hard to do that. Anyway.
Possible now, speaking from experience also.
Yeah. Anyway. The other team, formerly known as Wow Wow Kapow, doesn't have their Brazilian banana throwing. I forgot my last descriptive word for Pow, but they don't have their all-star this game because Pow is having some family issues. He's got to move out of his house, whatever. He's got to move into a new tree. Anyway, their stud scout is gone, and that gives a huge advantage to Down to Pound. Uckum and Decimate are both ex-invite scouts. So they definitely have experience and DM over the Steve C Games crew. Steve C Games, it doesn't look like they have the advantage anywhere based on what I'm seeing. Like,
I'd say Christopher might be
the only Rando is definitely better than Doggles. So if their combo can really outmuscle him, it might be possible, but on this map it's scout demo dominated, so you know, what do you think of prediction wise?
I'd say Down to Pound coming off their Zensity win. Yeah, they're definitely going to be going through this match with confidence. So, and you know, Steve C Games not having power. I'd say 4-3 for Down to Pound. It's going to go a full hour, I think. Or we're not going to see five rounds.
I was going to give it 5-3, Down to Pound.
Yeah, I was trying to.
Just because I don't think IM teams can really hold nearly as effectively as invite teams, so I think like pushes will be easier. Although on the same token, it could go, you know, flip side.
Basically,
whoever fucks up on the push. As soon as you cross that door, that threshold into last, whoever fucks up right there will lose. I guess we're just waiting on somebody from Down to Pound? No, from Steve C.
They have 12 in a couple times, but people keep leaving and rejoining or something. Maybe
the
unlocks
Rando.
They're busted. Check the server stat, see if it's live on there.
It looks like, no, it's not live yet, but they have 12 on the server. Unless Doggles just gets 8 kills within like the next minute and a half.
I see it happening.
Randall says they're starting right now.
Doggles. No.
So they're starting in 90 seconds our time.
Is it 90 or 120? I guess we'll see. Blah. Oh, snake water.
You think Decimate's gonna snipe? I mean, it looks like he's warming up on Sniper.
Well, you know, pushing last, someone's always gonna snipe, and yeah, if it's Decimate or Outcome, I'd definitely say Decimate's the one gonna do it. As for Steve Seagames, I have no idea who they'd have run sniper or spy.
Isn't Steve C on Steve C? Like, where is
he?
No,
I think they just named it after him because he's on their roster.
Oh, I thought he was playing
for them.
No. He's gonna play. I was like ready to call out Steve C.
Steve C. Seagames.
Oh, DPW and Size are sitting in a tree. What are they doing?
Let's see. What's going?
F-U-C-K-I-N-G. No one can stop him, he says.
I thought it was her and Paladin, actually.
What?
That's who the couple used to be. It was
DPW
and
right.
Paladin.
That's right.
Or something like that. TF2, the game of couples.
Rando said, never mind, they aren't ready.
Uh-oh.
Don't worry, these guys might be an invite next season. They're already preparing.
They're ready to play against them. They'll speak. And all the invites, greatness.
DBW is down to pound. I like that. So now they got 12 in.
Who is I'm bad at PC games?
What?
They got, that's Frio. Okay. Oh my god, there's a fucking cricket that's loud as shit in my door. Be right back.
Reminds me of Season 6 Slam.
I know, I gotta take care of this.
So anybody in stream chat have any questions before we go live? Any burning desires that you guys want answered? What type of monkey is Paula? Brazilian baboon. Favorite food? I don't know, I have a lot of favorite foods. Depends on what genre you're asking about.
Alright, I got the chips ready, got the soda, I'm ready to
watch. Nice. Why do I always MG a soldier when I play demo in matches? Because I am a soldier. I'm not a demo man. I just play demo man in
matches. He's a soldier trapped in a demo's body.
Exactly. So I want my soldier DM to be up to par when I go back so I don't have to take 3 months to get back into it like Siegel.
It's never gonna happen though. You're a demo man for life.
No.
That's a demo.
No. Alright, Randall says he's going live.
Alright.
So we got 90 seconds.
Spicy ketchup flavored chips are the best. I recommend anyone who wants a new flavor of chip to try them. They're great. Doesn't sound like it'd be good on paper, but...
Yes, Thorn, my job's going well. Thanks for asking.
Is Thorn asking?
Yep.
He's trying to get in, dude. He's trying to get in.
I am an engineer. Ironically, I hate playing that fucking class in TF2. But I like it in real life.
I hate the class in general, especially
no,
in pubs.
I'm going back to soldier. Tyler's cut because of his attitude. He's got a bad attitude. He disses Highlander players and then he just causes internet fights.
Not to start any rumors, but let's just say LG Tyler.
Yeah, right. LG Tyler replacing Clockwork on Scout because he's definitely not playing Soldier. Alert. The control point is being contested. I'm gonna cheat. All right, I cheated. I know who to watch at mid.
Uh oh, check the stats.
Yep. No, I just checked the server info.
Yeah, that's all right, man. Yeah.
I don't know what's going on, Skybez. Wait till after LAN. Then we'll figure it out. Me and Harv might be quitting to go play League of Legends, you never know.
Let's just say LG Pure?
Let's just say LG Platinum?
Mix-up
Banny? Well, I almost spit my water all over my monitor when you said mix-up Banny. Am I giving you guys a seizure by doing this? Because we're about to go live, baby. Yeah, buddy. I am Grandfine. Upper Bracket Files. Here we go. This could be the future, you know, season 15 invite winners, guys. Like, you never know. Pay attention. History is being made right now.
Here we go.
Mighty Ducks Platinum and Harblue? Maybe. Alright, so we are going live here. I think that Down to Pound is going to come over and roll in this middle.
Who should I watch this mid?
Well, I'm going to go from Control Muffin to Decimate is what I'm going to do. Because I feel like DTP is going to win this middle through those two. Let's find out.
Gee, I wonder how you...
Alright, Control Muffin hits the first sticky on the demo, shoots some blind ones, not really a good choice here. But he puts some good damage on the medic. There's a lot of damage out right here.
Just get to Decimate.
Walks across the point, which is what you do. Decimate gets the first kill on the soldier. Now he's following up on the scout. Should shoot the other scout right there. Ends up taking him down. Now he's trying to... I wanted him to hunt down that other scout, but Decimate and Uckham completely decimating the other team. That was pretty good, guys. Down to Pound comes out with authority. They're Devilman plus forwards. Everybody else just bombs in and cleans up. The scouts clean up. I mean, that's how Snake Water works. If the other team doesn't do it, they're going to get swallowed up like you just saw there. That's why Snake Water mid is kind of fun when both teams have a clue, because they just clash right on the point, and it's pretty epic. But not what happened this round. So let's see if Down to Pound ends up screwing this push-up, because that's the only way
to lose this round. Doggles is on heavies for this push.
Yeah, Uckham, scouting some stuff out. Control Muffin not going with the Uber, I don't think, so I don't know why. Oh! Rapes the soldier, right. Now they're going in. That was a great play off of Control Muffin right there.
This Pyro's denied.
Decimate ends up getting him down. They need to get the gun down and get back to the heavy with the medic, is what DTP needs to do right now. Control Muffin's all over their combo. He ends up going down. Three down for Down to Pound. Four down for Down to Pound right now. Just the heavy remaining. I know heavy can do a lot of damage, but not against Christopher Gaming right here. Wow, he might kill them all! He might. Oh, no, that heavy. Too OP. So DBW ends up staying alive, so they're going to have a 96% uber disadvantage. Good job, DBW. Way to not commit on that fight.
Are they going to push out with this, though?
It doesn't look like Christopher is looking. He put a sticky trap in the bucket. I guess this is just an uber mismanagement call. They didn't know their huge advantage because they saw DBW. So DBW getting out actually bluffed them into not pushing.
I mean, they had to have known. They still had some advantage, but if you're not going to push out, they're actually looking like they're going to push now. They just lost one, but they're in lobby. They fell back, it looks like. Yeah.
We got top shot top.
If you're not going to push out on that, then you're really not going to push out on anything. They had full advantage, and the team was one up.
It looks like Down to Pound is trying to edge in here and get some.
Ooh, med dead. Sticky trap.
Wow. Oh, that was that same bucket trap that he set up earlier. So I guess it ends up working out for them. Maybe now they know they have an uber advantage. Maybe now they're going to push. I mean, Uckham goes down, so.
Okay,
dead. Full uber advantage. Let's see if Top Shot Ta is really Down to Pound on this medic right here and make him pop. Try and save this middle point. Because if they don't pop, they're going to just take middle back.
Yeah.
Scout sees him. Soldier too strong.
He's gonna get killed.
Soldier sees it. Run away, baby. Distract. He's buying so much time for his medic to get Uber right now.
I love what I'm seeing right now.
Yeah, this is a great play, even though it looks retarded. This is a great play delaying.
Well, he kills the soldiers.
See, it's making Steve C. He's still distracting. So great play from Top Shot. Now Steve C Gaming finally pushing in the middle with this Uber. Pops Uber and Top Shot goes down. So not the best timing for that, but they have 85% Down to Pound does. So they should be able to come back and recontest this because nobody's dying in this Uber right now. So here they come. They're coming back in. Steve C got no cap time. They're going to get rolled right here if this is a good Uber. So let's put it on the Rando cam.
They just fell off the point.
See if Rando can defend from this other Uber. But looks like he's about to get caught out right here. Rando's running for his life. All right, so DTP does pop. They need to bomb in with this Uber. All they did was get some ground and take over window room. Not a very effective Uber right there. I feel like there was way too many people around Down to Pound's Uber instead of just giving it to Doggles and letting him push and clear a hole for his team.
Yeah, they had tons of damage out on them, but they decided not to follow up on it.
Top Shot Ta on the medic directs him while he's hovering over the what Brad calls Africa and ends up taking him down, giving the advantage again to Down to Pound. So right now, a couple of I don't know, missteps from combos, being out of position, getting caught, sticky traps. I don't know, if it goes that way for the rest of the game, I could see Rando really turning it on. And
well, I mean, we just saw DTP push in with full Uber advantage and fail. So even if they get two here, which it looks like they're not going to, they lost three players. Even though they have like full Uber advantage.
Oh man, that was really poor DM right there by Doggles. Had a demo man pinned in a corner and failed to take him out. That could have been huge for his team. Now there's only three up or down to pound, but they do have full Uber advantage. I would like to see them playing up closer so they could Uber in and you know, just do massive damage for the respawns to come in, but
yeah,
playing back like this just it baits your whole team into getting popped like on a defense, like on your back heel, so you can't push back into them fast and do anything. So
I don't. Jorga's 80%, they're gonna get it.
Yeah, DBW is playing way too good. These guys want to win. You could tell they nobody wants to make a mistake, but it's forcing mistakes to happen because nobody wants to make a mistake.
Yeah.
So it looks right now like Doggles is pushing through window room, trying to call out some sticky traps. There's a sticky trap above the door. I'm not sure if he sees it yet. If he doesn't, he's blind. Because he
gotta
wasn't.
Spam it. You can see it right there.
I don't know if he sees it, because
they must see it.
He hasn't shot or made any move towards it, so
but
I don't
that,
know if he's
that
looking.
Does that damage you from all the way up there?
Yeah, it does. But it won't kill him.
Yeah.
All right, looks like Rando. Oh, Rando. I would have loved to see Drogo pop on him there, because he did tons of damage. And That's something I would do, is push into them like that, make them split, do lots of damage, and then call for a cleanup. But it didn't work
Drogo
out.
I think was disconnected. He was a little farther back.
Yeah, so a little miscommunication right there. Down, Steve C letting them get in for free, but
Steve C.
Steve C Gaming. Down to getting a lot of boy coming in here for a flank, trying to make this medic pop or kill this demo man. Yeah, does get the demo man, so that's a great job holding the point by Boink. He is going to try and follow up on this combo and rape him. I don't know why DBW stopped Ubering Doggles. That was... He could have easily got out with his pocket, but he didn't. Or she didn't. Whatever it is. All right. Now, Steve C Gaming going huge with a 3-kill on middle and taking the point back. So,
I didn't like how Steve C Gaming held that point at all. They almost gave up the point.
I did not like it either, but it ended up working out because Bonk saved the point from being capped.
Yeah. That was a clutch play.
That's just experience levels. Yeah, I mean, Boink just pressuring on the left side. He might go for the kill on this demo man. I would like to see him. He is going for it. He does get taken down, though. Great decision by Boink. Just didn't end up panning out. But he does force him back, so they can't pressure the point. And
now,
Steve C Gaming with a 70% Uber advantage has two. Let's see if they can get in some blasts without dropping their medic to a sticky trap.
Any heavy spawns? Nope, he's staying scout.
So we got one trap on the left, that sliding door, and we got a long-range trap being set up on the stairs, so the medic walks down there. It's hard to see. Never know. That's where the medic is going. Watching out for control markers.
Decimate on sniper.
No. Oh, Rando almost got blown up. I think he was getting a little greedy, wanted the medic, but
Rando's doing good damage with this Uber.
Yeah, control muffin not really doing any damage. I mean, he finally gets a kill, two kills, but man, he wasted a lot of time there. He wasted a lot of time not shooting anything, and I feel like that's why they lost. They had a great defense, even though Rando did damage, but Control Muffin was not putting out damage on anybody. He was spamming rollers at the demo a mile away.
Yeah, he almost had it, but too little, too late.
Well, let's watch Mr. CTFC Gaming, Christopher.
I'm watching Control Muffin again, see if he just.
All right, let's see the demo fight. So Christopher hits the pole with the first sticky, whiffs on that guy.
Control Muffin was really slow that mid. He just got the mid, so.
Oh, so he's pulling a numlog. The roamer jumps on Christopher. Christopher ignores and goes forward. DTP going down, four people right now. Let's see what Decimate can do if he gets called out by the two scouts, run over by Kapow. Wow, Alcum comes in with a huge flank. Safe. Unacceptable with five people alive. Absolutely unacceptable right there to lose your medic to a scout.
Yeah, I felt like I was watching mix up right there.
I know, it's like almost like when we when we strip. But Steve C Gaming is gonna get this uncontested.
Soldier going. Shelf Muffin almost picked Soldier in top lobby. There he is. He's down.
DBW. Yeah, they could have retaken. If this was invite, they would be retaken because they would have known they had heal advantage. But since I am, I don't know if they're going to be successful. They're only 15% up on Uber. They're pushing up to maybe try to get some pressure on. But let's see. Alchem Cam, the sparkling lights, chasing the scout down, pushing him out. Nice job by Kapow bringing in the heavy like he did all game against Vector. Really good timing for the heavy. So just completely preventing the push out from DTP and allowing his team to get Uber. Gets two kills in there too, so heavy too easy?
Yeah.
Maybe. But The timing of the heavy is what really threw off down to pound right there.
Caught the stickies.
I would have liked to see them throw in two bodies right there with three down for DTP, but they're just deciding to opt for the Uber, and then they're going to push in and probably walk the heavy as slow as they can. So I'd like to see DTP go heavy to counter it, but it doesn't look like they're doing that. They're just standing standard lineup for last, and it's kind of a mistake, and I think they're going to lose this push because of it. Their egos might be getting the best of them. I don't know. What do you think, Hub?
I would like to see well, they have a sniper. Destiny's on sniper, so, you know, he's going to try and pick that heavy or medic when they come in, which is good.
So he finally did switch. Soldier bombing in onto the sniper doesn't do anything. Rando bombs in too, so they're bombing in two people.
Oh, I like this.
Boink is in. Okay, they drop three people one by one by one. So hopefully the respawn timers for them is the same, or else they're going
to
be in
trouble. Well, they have the heavy, so, you know, it should be pretty easy for them to hold two.
Right, but the heavy's in. Oh, the demo's about to go down. Oh, huge save by Christopher.
I like it. The heavy's going to go down, though. Heavy was caught up top.
That was a very bad position mistake. If you're going to do that, you have to be back in a better position than that.
They have the respawns here now, though, and they
do.
This is going to be
three dead for DTP, so they could follow this up. Four down for DTP. It's just Control Muffin and...
Ooh, wait.
Control Muffin gets one. Up comes back up. Control Muffin, spam up top, buddy. There you go. Control Muffin looks completely flustered right here. What is he doing? He's not putting out, not helping a scout at all. Oh my, is he out of ammo? Uckum just going huge, getting a two kill right there while his demo man's fucking around.
He must be out of it. Twitching. He's just spamming pills.
There you go. Did he pick him up? Whatever. I'm getting off that guy. We're going to go on the Uckum cam. He seems to be playing really well. So they're pushing out lower, so they could have a double soldier bomb right here. Top shot right here, going in. Going to get a pick on the scout. Okay, the scout goes down, so they're going to be able to retake this. There is no backup attempt from Steve C. So another failed push. This could be a 1-0. You never know.
That's what I'm expecting. I mean, the IM teams, they get the picks, and they get too, like, excited. And in that push, they lost the scout before the rest of the team even got in. So, you know, they just have to get all their players in and going together and win it. Not one by one.
So Doggles right here taking the Uber up top. It's pushing in the middle. Gets hit by a pipe. He needs to get into them. Like, Doggles is trying to, like, slow push the shit out of this. Which I can respect if you're not trying to pop, but if you're sitting that far back, you're going to end up popping if the other team puts enough pressure. Dog is going for the flank right now. Ends up getting taken down by Boink coming through the window. Gets a two kill. So I'd like to see Rando trying to get a position to retake this while those two people are down. 16 seconds till spawn. So it looks like Rando is about to push with this Uber. Great decision by him right here if he can get into the other team and make them split. Puts a lot of damage on that soldier, and then the medic pops. So Rando did his job right here. His team needs to come in and swarm on whatever they can swarm on. The soldier dead by Rando. Great job right now. Scout's taking some damage. Steve C Gaming needs to get in here and get position, and do not let them come back into the choke.
Position.
Yeah, DTP is not going to recontest that. So great play from Rando there. Like I said, if it comes down to the combos, I think Rando's going to take this game. And if he keeps doing stuff like that, it's going to look really good for them.
I mean, you know, that was all caused by Doggles and the scout trying to do too much after they took the point. Doggles tried to get that kill on the medic and ended up getting picked, and the scout died too. So they ended up losing the point right after they got it.
So Christopher, putting some pressure from long range onto their combo. Decimate does go down, their main fragger for DTP. So DTP's going to have to give this up again. I don't like it. They're not fighting. They're not playing with the confidence that they had against Zensity, because... both teams had the exact same amount of Uber, and DTP just gave up the point, and you cannot do that. You have to fight it, and if you wipe, you wipe. I mean, you can't just give it up, go to last. Here we come, the Uber from Rando coming in, making DTP split a lot. DBW not able to keep up with Rando's fast twitching abilities. Here, Doggles putting a lot of pressure on, Kapow goes down. Doggles might get another kill over here on the Soldier. Gets the other kill on the Soldier, so Doggles doing well. Gets a triple, nope, Control Muffin KSS him, but that's all right. Doggles, 2.5 kills on that push. Good hold from Doggles, even though Rando had a much better Uber. The reason that happened was because everybody for Steve C Gaming fell out that right sliding glass door, and it was just, oh, all I have to do is click at the door and you all die. So.
Oh, Doggles, what did you do? He was like, there were two up and he was needling into last. And then tried to fall
Doggles?
Out and got caught.
Drogo. I saw that. I didn't want to call him out on it because I thought there was a reason, but I didn't see it.
No, he could have easily gone out of there, but he shot needles in for no reason when the other team was 5 up.
So it's like Miari. It looks like DTP taking over this middle, going to take down a soldier at least. How he went did not die is beyond me, but DTP has full Uber advantage. I would like to see them already pushing this because they have established it on the point. I'd like to see them take a scout with a soldier and just completely run over Steve C Gaming right here. So it looks like their entire team is going to be going through choke. Hopefully a scout doesn't get picked early this time. Looks like their Doggles goes down to Pipe Roller. That's unacceptable. Decimate ends up taking down a soldier. Two dead for DTP, so their push is ruined because their players got ahead of the Uber. Again, unacceptable pushes from their team. Just getting overzealous. It's not like the other teams are doing that good of a job defending. Kapow goes down to a Sticky Trap. It's just people running in when they don't have to.
Are they really going to give up middle here? They had Uber. Why'd they give that up?
Let your pockets do their job. If you go in like that, your pockets can't do their job. This is a horrible decision by Doggles, coming in after they cap the point and popping 5 seconds before Rando's Uber. Doggles is trying to do something behind, but as long as Rando doesn't get overextended here, that was fucking retarded by Doggles.
Here comes Doggles in. Gonna
shoot. Rando whiffing. No. All right, two dead for DTP. The Demo Man is going to go down here. Demo Man down as well for DTP.
Med's going to get chased. Med's.
So Rando doing a good job protecting his medic. Now, as long as Steve C Gaming doesn't get overextended and just die to Uckum because he has been raping them all game, then they should be fine.
That was such a bad play. They waited until the other team capped middle, and then they Ubered like 3 seconds in. Like,
for no reason. No, they weren't even any pressure. That was a horrible decision from Doggles. Maybe realizing, hey, I should have pushed in. Let me do it now anyway. No, cut your losses, dude, and reset. Yep. So you think this is going to be our first successful last push of the game, or you think this is going to be a 1-0 the rest of the game?
Although we have Boink on Sniper now, so...
So quick stat check. It looks like Christopher has 3 doms, so he is playing really well. And I guess when you're a DM demo and the other team doesn't have very much teamwork, I mean, you're going to dominate, so... Let's see. I'm going to watch the Christopher cam to see if he can do stuff at this last.
Scout.
Nice flame from Uckum. That's that experience. But Kapow has, they lost two. Rando goes down, so it does kind of equalize it out with the Uber. I don't know who's going to use the Uber. Scout gets air shot, so nice shot by the soldier, putting cap time. They pop for no reason. The medic is full health. The heavy was near him. Her, whatever it is.
I think it was to save the scout, which was 30 HP, but in that case, I'd say just let the scout
die. Oh, these medics are killing me, man. All right, so... Kapow ends up going down, so the heavy play not working out as well as it did on Viaduct against Vector. Still, nonetheless, down the town, try and roll over them, because they have a sniper, so I would like to see Decimate and Uckum get aggressive, which is exactly what they're doing. But they're just trying to take out the sniper. Yeah, that was a great air shot from Miranda, but Boink ends up going down, and they give up a point, so as good of a shot as it is, they got to reset anyway, so... Randall's got 80%, so he's moving over to the left. I like where his positioning is, because he's going to try and overload this flank and get a couple kills with this Uber on the left.
This could be a good Uber if they use it here. The med's close.
Oh, he hits the demo. Go, Randall, go. If he hits this shot on the demo, huge shot from... Oh, Randall doesn't get the demo.
The med's not...
If Randall could get this medic, Randall's got to get this medic. Oh, he hits him. Oh, gets taken. Hey, got him. Wow. Great shot by Randall. He just won his team that push if the medic stays alive.
95%.
Nope, top shot on him. Can top shot hit the air shot? Missed him. The scout is on the Drogo. Drogo, 9 health. Can he get finished? He gets taken down by Control Muffin. All right. A huge fuckfest going on right now, but DTP comes out on top, surprisingly, after that Uber from Miranda. Woo! I am, baby! All right, let's do it. Here, you take over while it's boring.
They're Captain Mid. They're still Captain Mid. I mean, both medics are up. We got another hold here. Even Ubers.
So one person that Christopher had dominated killed him, so that's exciting news.
That was an exciting push. Doggles didn't work great on push. That. He killed the demo and something else when hit some good rockets, so he pretty much saved that one.
What I would like to see here is for DTP to try and just, like, be confident, like, on their middle and just go out the choke and try and push him back without Uber, but it doesn't look like that's what's gonna happen. I'm expecting Top Shot and Uckum to go in. Suicide try and get their medic or demo.
I would have liked to see Prince from one of the teams right here, actually.
Yeah, that would have been a good decision, too. Yeah. That would have been something an IM team would do, like, you know, standard, okay, I have advantage if I go crits here. But it looks like the medics on both teams are kind of, like, uncomfortable. It looks like Doggles is pushing in against Rando.
Way early.
Rando takes a lot of damage, but gets popped. Dog's just body blocking. Rando is going to chase him down.
That was a long Uber.
That was a really bad decision to go for a scout there, Rando. But Top Shot goes down. Rando looks like he's going to go down. Escapes. No, he's out. Kapow 1v1ing Decimate over here. Both scouts are just shooting each other and missing. Decimate ends up going down. So 2-3 down for DTP. Yeah. Great flank, but I'm bad at PC games. So apparently you're not that bad, buddy. great flank right there. 4 up for DTP. Rando and crew. Boom! There it is right now. So I'm bad. Just lived up to his name right there. That's the most predictable sticky spot in
man,
the snake
Doggles level. Has done nothing with any of the Uber pushes. They've been so ineffective.
I'd like to see them give it to Uckum because Rando is having effective Ubers and his team's just dying after it. Yeah. But Doggles is just making his team lose because he's just horrible Ubers, not doing anything.
I mean, either give it to the scouts or the devil.
Or do something.
But yeah, Doggles hasn't done like a single thing with any of these
Uber pushes. Look at how slow he walks. You can't do that. Like, you're just going to get right. Pops that early.
They're coming back in. He's early again. Why?
He's just spamming long range 20 damage rockets that aren't going to do anything. Now he jumps away. I'm bad at PC games. Go down again. He is pretty bad at PC games. Decimate goes down. One down for each team right now. Doggles walking back, not shooting anybody. I'm getting off the Doggles cam. two dead for each team right now. And Steve C ends up looks like he's going to win this fight. Because the rest of Doggles not even looking. He's just running backwards.
The scouts are just shooting them.
Okay, I don't know.
Is his mouse broken?
Maybe his monitor turned off, but he just caused the round loss for his team. Steve C Gaming needs to start going now while everybody's freaking dead. They don't need to wait for Uber. So.
Oh my gosh. I'm sick. I'm getting sick.
Yeah. Man. Like, turn around and use your shoddy, dude. Like, anything. Anyway. Rando needs to have a good Uber here, and they win the fight. Decimate is on Sniper, so the only pick that I can really see working on this push for Decimate is if he takes the demo out right when the Uber starts.
I would like to see a Pyro or something by Down to Pound here.
They do have a Heavy.
Yeah, but I guess the Sniper is a quick shot. Let's see if the Sniper hits. Alright.
Got the Rando cam.
Decimate.
Pop. Alright, they popped out. So Rando put it, okay, they're getting on the Heavy, which is a good decision. Heavy goes down early, so this is really bad for Down to Pound. Rando pushing the combo. Get onto the point, Steve C Gaming. Get onto the point. And Rando takes down a lot of them. Nice Uber by Rando. Great team push right there. Only lost one player, and it's 2-0.
Picture perfect. They forced the other team into spawn and then just went on the point and they have come to them.
From there it's just shoot the ground. Get kills. Let's watch Rando. He's playing a
four doms
for Christopher. Let's see if he loses it in this mid. I feel like they're all from assist though, because I don't think he's getting that many kills. He's just not dying, which is good as Devilman. I mean, that's good. So he is putting a lot of damage. Oh, he's getting a lot of damage right now, putting tons of damage and opening it up for his team. Christopher just not getting any pressure on him, so he can just walk forward and rape.
Yeah.
Looks like Down to Pound is not down.
Hits
the pipe! Oh,
still at four. Still, who we need.
Sorry, he didn't die, and he's fully buffed. Like, there's no pressure. DTP is losing that confidence. And this is without power. This is without power that they're losing,
I'd say they're losing the confidence just from all these failed, like, Ubers.
Yeah,
they don't trust
the combo. The team breaks down. Like, that's what happens. Christopher sees the sticky trap on the left, so he's going to call for his team to go right. I fully expect Rando to push in the right. I don't know why they're not doing it already, but that's just Uber mismanagement from the medics. Not having a clue, but it's typical.
Let's see if he can.
They still have a
50%
advantage, so.
Let's go, Decimate.
All right, Rando taking the Uber in the same spot. Now checking and drop down for somebody. Taking a lot of time here, Rando. You got to go, buddy. You got to go.
Yeah, 70%. 70? 80? Oh, this is gonna be bad.
So they pop in. If they can get the demo right here, that would be good. I mean,
they can't. They got him.
Yep, they get the demo down. So now, as long as Christopher stays alive, right here, he can just.
97% DBW.
Medic heal. Oh, 3-0. Steve C Gaming coming in hot.
The soldier there the soldier jumped away to not even try and stop point. He like chased the kill instead of getting the Uber with the medic and then just walking the point with it. Questionable.
Again, miscommunication from DTP, soldier, and their medic. I mean, Rando was completely taking advantage of it, just like I said would happen if, I mean, At this level, if you have a good pocket soldier, you can get carried pretty hard, and it looks like that's what's happening. I mean, I know Christopher is having a great game, but it's because of the things that Rando is doing.
Yeah. I mean, this is surprising to me right now. I thought the demo and scouts for DTP, you know, they would be doing better than Steep Sea Gaming, and they'd be, you know, it'd be enough to make up for their soldiers being weaker, but...
Apparently not.
Rando is just, yeah, outplaying Doggles so much that it's... I mean, if they have weaker scouts and missing power and Uber, it doesn't matter. The Ubers are just so much more effective right now.
Yeah, because if everything's weak, it doesn't matter how good a scout you are. All you gotta do is click once and they die. So, I mean, that's what Rando and Christopher are doing. They're just putting out massive amounts of damage. Like, Rando gets in their face, hits 112 damage rockets. Doggle stays back and shoots 30 damage rockets. Over the course of the fight, that's like 600 damage difference. So, that's where they're losing it.
Stats.
Harblue, you have a personality of a wet towel from Truth Detector. Can you spice it up a little bit? Thanks.
No. I'm boring. Just the facts.
Alright, let's get a stat check.
Christopher top fragging, so I guess it's not all from assists, but only four deaths.
Four deaths, that's huge. His medic has seven, so Christopher playing apparently not like dummy at all, just playing a smart demo man and you know, 288 damage per minute, not that much. Rando with 382 damage per minute. Which is expected. Whoa. So it looks like Christopher staying back, playing off Rando's damage. It's fine. One person has to do the starting damage. One person has to finish. And if that's how they want to play it, that's how they want to play it. And it's working. Yeah.
That Rando damage compared to Doggles is like, that's the
Doggles,
right there.
264 damage per minute. Rando, 382 damage per minute. Rando's hitting another rocket and a half per minute direct on people. Like, point blank. Like, that's you're just completely getting shit on Doggles. Like, if you don't turn it up in the second half, if your team, you'll lose 5-0.
I mean, you know, it's either Doggles picks it up or they just switch how they're using their Ubers. Because right now they're just Ubering Doggles in and he's not doing anything. They should switch to either the scouts or demo, taking them in, and having the soldiers come in after.
Yeah, Control Muffin's putting out basically the same damage as Christopher, so it's not him. It's the combo. Combo play, medic play for TTP. So let's try to see what Doggles does on this middle. I'll get to him after Christopher. Initial rollout. But let's see if he steps it up the second half to try and make this a game. Christopher nails the demo in the face with the first sticky. Christopher putting out lots of damage. Gets the air sticky almost. Wow, DTP getting really aggressive. I think Doggle's already dead. I missed it. But
yeah.
Looks like it's 2-2, 1-2. Kapow versus Decimate. Decimate one health. Nice. And man, if DBW committed with this team and trusted the team, they would have won that. But now, it's a reset. I mean, maybe Doggles isn't going to get there fast enough to stop this middle point.
When I see that from a medic, when there's like two players left alive and like the medic's already like at their second.
If it's 2-on-2 and you're playing with your player and you're a medic, like even if you don't think you could heal him enough, you still have the ability to Ubersaw and fight, like, and distract for your player. Just leaving him out to dry. You might get chased down, you might not, but if you stay in and you trust your player, it gives them confidence. It's just like an overall team-building thing.
Yeah.
Like,
I mean, they have that vintage now, but whoever...
Oh, no! DBW gets popped by long-range rockets! Are you kidding me? Rando hitting the meat from a mile away and popping their Uber. That was just piss-poor dodging by DBW, not paying attention.
Hey, 130 ping.
Kapow right now just jumping around trying to do whatever he can. Trying to save the medic. Ends up going back to Drogo, which is a great play by Kapow.
Yeah.
Gonna be able to take down the soldier if he can aim. There we go. Takes him down.
Three dead.
Control Muffin setting up a good trap right now. Let's see if this works. Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh my god. It's the dummy spot. It's the dummy spot.
I have no idea what the dummy spot
is. It's a choke. Oh, Christopher playing too smart finds it because they... See, if that was us, we would have got caught by that because we would want to push that right away. We would want to push that right away, but they wanted to push so slow that they were able to find the trap like 10 years before it was able to be used. But it's just all this doing giving DBW a chance to get Uber, but I mean, Steve C is up by 3. They don't really need to push this, but they're going to try anyway.
Looks like they are.
Christopher leading the Uber and pushing them back, not even going to have to pop because there's no roamer pressure. So great decision from Steve C to push in right there without Ubering. Get position on the point, get a lot of cap time. That's exactly what you want to do. Rando goes down, so this is a bad damage potential, but...
They're going through kitchen with the Uber.
All right, well, they again, too fucking slow. too slow. They lost the point, and they get counter-popped right now. Later. Doggles, get high position. Okay, that's the best thing you could have done right now. Don't try to aim at that scout. Go for the medic, because now the soldier is going to blast you away. All right. Doggles having, like, the worst game of his life right now and costing his team this match. Now he tries to go for the medic and does nothing. That was just... The combo play...
It's the Uber,
Steve C.
Yeah.
Gaming is... I don't know how to stress this enough. They are raping. Bending them over, spreading it wide open, penetrating into their soul right now with the Uber fights. That's how bad that Rando and crew are beating down in the Uber fights.
Mean,
that's the game right there.
I mean, you know, you can try and say it's any, you know, so many different things, but it's the Uber. Simple as that.
Doggles hits an air shot on the scout's face and doesn't die, but doesn't go for the kill. Just starts spamming long range rockets at the medic.
And they're walking in again.
So DTP gets taken down twice by Rando and Kapow. So Steve C, Rando going in with this. Well, it's okay. Rando got the Uber. Now I'd like to see Rando push in with this Uber and try and split them. You know, they do have spawn advantage.
They have the cap time also.
They have the cap time and they have the heavy. So. Walk it in, Rando. I guess what they could do is park the bus because they really want to win, but they don't need to do that. They could just win it right now. Their combo play has been so much, like, so superior. So, Rando, checking out the drop down. Maybe they're taking.
Headshot
Rando drop down, so gonna halt that push, but.
Yeah, they're slowing this down, it looks like.
Which is fine. It's fine. If you're up 3-0, you can slow it down, take all the time you want, freaking cap this point.
I feel like we might see another three-person bomb since they have a heavy right now.
It looks like they're setting up for it. Or they might be pushing in right with the Uber, but scouts are taking a lot of damage. So Rando peeking this right door here. Not trying to look at... Okay, Rando pushes in with the Uber. Gonna try and force the medic, which he does do pretty quickly, so that's good. Now if he can get some damage on the demo, which he does, gets 100 damage on the demo, now gets out in a nice position. Good Uber from Rando.
They fall out.
If they get a couple kills, if not, they reset. I mean, yeah. I like what I saw from Rando right there. Great Uber, got out, knew nothing was going to happen of it because the way he got juggled, got out, lost nobody, they have a heavy reset. Throw some suicide bodies, try to get a couple kills, and then push in. Great play right there from Steve C. Playing like a lower half, medium invite team right there. Pretty good.
Yeah, I mean, that was like a low-risk play, but...
It worked. I mean, if they get one or two kills while the Uber's going on, game over. But they reset perfectly. They are building a little bit faster, so I mean, I don't think they know that, but
yeah, they won't know. Ooh.
Christopher goes down. DTP is going to make the mistake of pushing out because Doggles wants to try and overcompensate, and they're going to lose this round. Calling it right now.
Yeah, Doggles is trying to go top lobby. He shoots the ground in front of him for some reason. Just give it up. It's too late. He's already spawned. Why are they still going in?
Nope. Doggles pops way early. Drogo actually does counter pop, but Decimate goes down to the heavy real quick. And it looks like the scout's going to go down on the point too. So two dead, four dead for DTP. Just like I said, poor decision. He just really... Oh, man.
Oh. I mean, okay, he gets a heavy, but he has to do clutch
medic,
plays.
So go to point and drag him. All right, 4-0. Steve C Gaming just completely outplaying them during with the Uber advantages. Completely outplaying them.
I mean, if there was like, you know, 10 minutes left in the game, I could see why I tried to push there, but
30 minutes,
the second half just started, and Christopher was already spawned by the time they actually committed to that terrible decision.
Alright, let's see if Uckham can try and turn this around, because it seems like he's the only one doing the right things for his team, even though not much he can do. He's pressuring the scout on the left, so there's a great pressure, but just great, but I'm bad. Two dead for DTP, they are crumbling at this point. Three dead. Doggles trying to get the medic here, ends up, is gonna take him down. Oh, goes for the air shot on the demo! Goes for the air shot on the fucking demo instead! You gotta be shitting me. Oh my god. Every decision that Doggles has made has been horrible in this game. Absolutely horrible. That was something fucking TLR would do. Ugh. God, it makes me sick. Hits a medic, hits a direct rocket on the medic, juggles the demo up, goes for the air shot on the demo. Didn't even kill a demo, did he? Like,
no.
All right, Rando, let's take it home. Show this team what a combo does. I'm bad at PC game going down. Might stop this push, but Rando managing it well enough, he could do whatever the hell he wants at this point, and it would be golden. Scout's gonna get called out. Rando needs to back up now because
they might get forced.
Yeah,
They could push into it. I mean, I wouldn't. I would fault him if you. But the respawns are all staggered. That okay.
Let's see if Rando.
Rando goes in. Ubers. Now Rando has to get this meta because of his decision. Because this back cap now. He goes back for the.
If they kill me, Scouts it too.
Oh, fail jumps. Now if he gets this Devilman too. Devil took a lot of damage. Okay, Scouts can follow up. Kapow tries to follow up on it. Doing Kapow playing pretty good this game. Going
look,
unsung hero too.
You can stop the point. Oh no.
I don't know who mentored.
They had full advantage there, and you know, eventually you're gonna have to retake two.
You gotta man the fuck
that was
up.
Perfect time.
At the right spy. Time.
Oh, I thought we were gonna have a spy play. It was just for forward spawn. Upsetting. Look, if they try and push out now into top lobby, this is. Oh my gosh, please, just fall back to last.
Nope,
it's
they're going lower, because that'll work.
They can stop.
Oh yeah, just shoot upwards. That'll do it. So you can go back now. You can still go back.
Douglas with a big flank play.
Oh, that left-handed rocket jump for 2 feet. All right, end up getting the demo, so that's good. But, okay, so Douglas having a good Uber. Kills three. Kind of bad positioning from Steve C Gaming because they could have just walked in up top and back cap very easily. Because that was such a slow-developing push that somebody with more experience would have been able to call that for that team. But
I believe, as Justin said, it was more Steve C being bad than Douglas and then being good.
I
mean,
would agree with that. All or right. a connection.
Crash.
Yeah.
DDoS? Hopefully that's not the end of the game. I think it's the end of the game. Sir Stevie shutting down.
All right. Well, in that case, we know that DTP or Steve C Gaming comes in with the Zuber and rolls through him and wins.
Yeah.
So. 5-0. Let's see. Is that you confirmed?
Yeah.
All right, so sorry you didn't get to see the last roll, but I'm assuming Rando went in and just shit on everybody.
we can you know try and predict what happens.
So Doggles ended up getting his DPM up a little bit and. But his total damage was the same that Rando had at halftime. Rando with 13,000 damage, 375 damage per minute. Huge game from him on pocket. Great job following his damage up. Was Kapow top fragging 34 and 18. Christopher doing decent damage, about the same DPM as Control Muffin, like 20 more. So it looks like Kapow playing off Rando's damage is what really won it for them. And oh, god awful Uber play from. From down to pound, so if they want to beat Zensi in the lower bracket, I can tell you that they're gonna have to do a lot better on those Ubers. And I don't know if that means switching Doggles back to Medic or what, but they're not gonna win against Zensi if they play like they just played with their combo.
Well, you know, Snakewater, it's a map where the Ubers, it's so easy to like get away from them and everything like that, and that's what Steve C was able to do against all of Doggles' Ubers. They're just able to force them early and like get away. Really
but I mean, that's a function. A of the map, but B more the way that Doggles was pushing. Like it just...
Yeah, I agree. But you know, depending on whatever map the lower bracket finals in, it could suit his Uber style more, which
I agree.
A more passive one.
Well, anyway, I guess tune in because Zensity should be playing down to pound again for a rematch, either probably next week, right? Sometime next week. We don't know when, but if we're not scrimming, then we might cast it again. So, thanks for. Hanging in there with us, guys. Hope you enjoyed it. Even though it was a 5-0, it was kind of an entertaining 5-0. So,
Some big plays on both sides.
Yeah.
Some sloppy plays by both sides, which can make it
sloppy
interesting.
Sloppy play makes it interesting, so I like it. Anyway, this is Platinum and Harblue. Thanks for watching. We'll see you guys later.
Later.